Hello my dear friends, and welcome to the 8th week of online faculty development program. This week is based on digital and advanced pedagogy. Myself Rakesh Daude from Department of Pharmacy, GP Jalgaon, and I am come up with how to create Google form, slide and sheet. After watching this video, you will able to create and use forms, slide and sheet for enriched teaching. Google form allow user to create forms, to take surveys, to take quizzes, as well as to collaboratively edit and share form with other people. Teacher can use Google form to assess their students at the beginning of class and gauge pre-existing knowledge. Google form can be used to give feedback to and to receive feedback from students and parents. Student can use Google form to assess their own learning and set the learning goals, as well as to collect data for research project. Now we'll see how to create a Google form. Google form can be created by two methods. Just type Google form in Google and you will get a Google personal and business type of form. Go to the personal, that is, go to the Google form, and immediately a pre-designed templates are open from where you can choose like blank, contact information, RSVP, party invitation, etc. You can also create a Google form by go to the Google app, go to the Google Drive, and in Google Drive you have to select new. In new, go to the more, and in more you will see the list. Here you have to select Google form. A new Google form will be open. Another thing, that is to go for Google slide, Google Documents, Google Sheet, you have to again go to the Google app. Just go down and you can select Google Documents, Sheets, Google Slide. Or you can also go through Google Drive. Just click to the new, and here, from here you can select Google Documents, Google Sheets, Google Slide. Google Documents is same as that of Microsoft Word. Google Sheets are like Excel or spreadsheets. Google Slides is nothing but a presentation. Only the thing is that MS Word and MS Office, it is working as an offline, and here you have to work as an online way. Now we will go to the blank form. How to design a blank form? Just click on the start a new form. You can see a untitled form which is present here. I am giving a title, that is a survey on teaching pedagogy. You can also add the description to this title. This survey, or you can write down the objective of this survey are, you can write your own objectives. Then go to the creating various different types of questions. You can see here untitled question, and I am writing here name of a teacher, and immediately you can see it has selected as a short answer. You can select your own, or you can create your own questions. There are various types of questions like short answer, paragraph, multiple choice like A, B, C, D option, check boxes where you can select more than two options, a drop down list where you can choose from the list, file upload, you can upload an image as well as a video. Embedding an image or a video, which is a great way to assess what student thinks and learn immediately after viewing an image or a video. You can go to the linear scale also, which can scale down from 0 to 5, which is just type of rating or giving a feedback. You can also choose an multiple choice grids and checkbox. On the start of the faculty development program, our coordinator has taken a survey, that is entry level survey. You can, if you are selected as an, if you are taken as a summary of that form, you can see there multiple choice grids and checkbox which has been created. You can also go to the date and time, and you can see here if you have to duplicate this form, this question, just you have to select the duplicate option. If you have to delete this question, go to the delete, and if you required just this to be present in the spreadsheet, just click on the required. There is one more thing, you can add the description of this question also, and you can go for the response validation of this question. Toward this side you can see this, there are additional tools, that is to adding the question, just click on the plus sign, import questions, add title, add image, video and add section. I'm going for another question like gender. Immediately you can see that it is giving suggestions. It is a multiple choice question and it is required in the spreadsheet. One more question I am adding, that is highest qualification. I am choosing it as an drop down, and options are like B-Farm, add an option, M-Farm, PhD or PharmD, etc. And I am selecting required, as it is required in to create a spreadsheet. And you can add a various types of question here, as we have discussed. You can see here on the top there is add-on options, where you can add several types of templates, several types of softwares. We'll see this later on. You can customize the themes. You can choose an image to the Google form. For example, I am adding this image, or you can add your own image. Just you have to insert this. You can also change the color of Google form, the background of Google form, and basic font size of Google form. Then you can see that if you have to preview this, how it live, just have to click this and you can see here your Google form, how it looks. Then you have to go for a setting. If you have to set for a quiz, make this as a quiz. You can shuffle the questions, go to the progress bar, shuffle question order, submit link to the another response. I am not creating it as a quiz. There are some general settings like collect an email address of a respondent. You can, if you require, a limit to one response or number of response the respondent can give. Respondent can also edit after submission and see the summary chart and the text response. You can see, as we have added a collect and email address from a respondent, immediately the email address, it has been added here, and such type of Google Forms which I have added few questions here. If you have to take response, how many people have responded to our form, you can select from this area and you can see that nobody has responded. I am giving one response, like you have to go to the preview, email address, then I am answering few questions. Which we have created, and you can see send me a copy of my response, which will go to my email address. Just you have to click here. And after this, you have to click on submit. You can see that your response has been recorded, and you can see here one response is generated. The detail of this, who has responded, it comes here, and in the pie diagram, what questions, how questions we have designed, and same type of things we are getting here. We can crop this and make the presentation, and also we can see this or import this in the spreadsheet. Now, how to create a spreadsheet of our Google form? You have to click on this green cross symbol and just click this, and you can see our spreadsheet has it designed. Depends on how the questions we have formed. In this way, as the students or respondents give their response, a number of response will be added in the spreadsheet here. In this way, you can create a Google form and share to the students for taking a survey, taking a quizzes, and taking a response of a student, or you can say a feedback of a students. Now we'll see how to add a password to the Google form. This is the Google form, and go to the add section. Immediately you can see there are two sections. The section one, as we have clicked to the collect the email address, this is section two. I am giving a title as an password, and go to this add a question like password, and this is required. Go to the response validation. You'll see the number, it should be equal to, an example I am selecting as an this number, and if the respondent is not writing the correct password, you can just write down oops here or type your own. You can see here, for going to the password, the respondent or the student has to fill the email address. If it is wrong, then there will come oops or sorry, whatever you have to write down there. In this way, you can also put up the password in the Google form. In this video, you have seen how to create a Google form, how to add a password, how to change the theme, and how to create a spreadsheet from a Google form. Thank you. Thank you very much.